It's game day here in sold-out San Francisco at Levi's Stadium. Both teams look primed to kill each other for our entertainment. And I am getting visibly excited just thinking about what's to come.
You know what I call your visible excitement, Grim? A San Francisco treat.
Bricks, do me a favor. Don't make eye contact with me for the rest of the game. I'm a little uncomfortable now. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Los Angeles Volts take on the San Francisco 40 Nightmares. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And NFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pig flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline. And it's first and 10. This guy, and that's a run for no gain. Second down and 10. Third down and 3. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
And it's first and 10. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. Must be their lucky day. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
That was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crack their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now, but damn it.
Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, with the brutal hit. And that'll bring up third and 1.
Nobody can touch him with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about? Pop?
Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this on here. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. It's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot,
And they stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and nine.
Hot one, hot two.
Leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond.
Cribbling, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and long. Interception, and that's how you stop an offense. Pow, with the brain scrambler. First and ten. Oh, man, Brooks, you gotta love a player. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere.
First and ten. Second down in a very lot. The defender says, I don't think so. Third down and long. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on NFL Game Day.
NFL is straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and ten. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I got
And that'll be second and eight to go.
Hot one, hot two, hot,
The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use it. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. greatest, I tell you.
Third down and nine.
Hot one, hot two.
Then put you to sleep permanently.
You snooze, you lose!
Unless you're in a sleeping contest.
You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
And a ball game snagged.
Hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckle.
The defense falls for that trick all the time.
Oh, my God. A man from prison just came onto the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. Second down in a mile. And oh, with the punishing hit. And it's first and ten.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and 10. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier better move his ass. Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and ten. Boom! Second down and ten. At this point, with multiple.
You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot
too.
That ball was almost intercepted. Second down and 10.
Hunt one, hunt two.
At this rate, the QB is going to have more interceptions than... Oh, with the brain scrambler. Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
Second down, the defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10.
Hunt one.
And he picks up maybe four on that play. Second down and 6.
Hunt one, hunt two, hunt eight.
Third down and the punter is warming up. It's a 6-yard gain on that catch.
I don't understand. Why are they going for it, Grim? This seems like the situation where they should always, always, always punt.
Well, tell our viewers the quarterback and the defense anticipated a pass there and put an end to their offensive drive. Like my wife always said, not tonight. The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only 2 left. They might consider running the ball more. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, I love this dirty trick. The quarterback, and he's off to the races. The 30. Someone better buy this guy dinner tonight because he just saved a touchdown with that. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. And it's first and 10. Assume that to orcs this is arousing somehow.
Assume all you want and don't make it true.
And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's when it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
That's another pick. Man, oh, man, the defense is going to have... Oh, great tackle. When, oh, holy smokes. first and 10.
Ah, another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck.
That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit.
Is that right, Finn? That penalty makes no sense.
And something ain't kosher here, and I'm not talking about the corned beef with extra mayo. Down in less than a, it's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho ho, crowd's loving it. And it's first and 10. More to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Second down and more than the QB would like. For this boom to the moon, another loser bites the dust, and the NFL winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
First and 8 to go. Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Second down and a lot. Ricks, it's the two-minute warning. You know what that means?
Whiskey?
Second down and long. Now, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You got to keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You got to make that catch.
Third down and, well, good luck. Oh, great play by the defense. The receiver didn't stand a chance. The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league.
Cheered. It's good to be good, huh? I mean, can we all just...
Not this shit again. Bricks, I'm stopping it right there.
Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. Smart move there as they call a timeout, trying to get the ball back for another shot. Third down and the punter is warming up. And boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham a sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow.
Bingo, bingo, I just hit that mutant bingo. And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays. Talk about luck.
And the offense has only 2 running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last 2 runners for this, Ekman.
it signals a hurry up.
Same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
And he's running like a moose right now. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort. And he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
Second, they stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
It's a nice catch for 5 yards. Third and two. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. A pickup of about 3 on that play. At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Ground Up. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. Boy, these guys are going to need to pull off a huge comeback in the second half to win this game. Here comes the kickoff.
We're at the coast. Why do we even come back and bother? This is a waste of my time.
Yeah, if only one team is gonna show up, why should we have to?
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Up about 6 on the play. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. Right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's 1st and 10. And there's another pick. Man, this... Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like... Well, that's a strange penalty call right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and he don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
First and goal. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's 1st and 10. second down and more than the QB would like. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant dingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
First and 10. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. And as they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no?
And the 40 Nightmares lose by forfeit. MMA fans call him tapping out, or as my stepdad would say, you're a loser and a quitter. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it.